Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In this episode, we're gonna see the number one most hidden feature in Qt Designer, namely, how can you hook up a bunch of radio buttons into a button group. Okay, I've created a very simple user interface in Qt Designer here. I have a button group here with choose one good thing, a hook, a song by Depeche Mode, or watching Qwam. Qwam? Qt Widgets and More, come on. It's like, it sounds one of those cartoons from the 80s where the bad guy and the good guy, they fight and it's like, Qwam! Am I getting besides the point? Okay, never mind. Let's review this. Alt-Shift-R inside my Qt creator, and you can see they work pretty well. So good. So far, so good. Next section is choose two, not just one, two bad things. Answering emails all day long, COVID-19, that's good things to say about that, but nevertheless, listening to me for more than, and you can specify the length here if you want to, see it's even, well, it is even when this is enabled. You can see it's checked, it gets enabled, so nice setup there, Jesper, thank you very much. You're too kind, thank you. And this is the first of the two bad things you could choose. And down here, you can choose the other set of the bad things. Getting a wisdom tooth pulled out. I tried that recently. I can tell you that's bad. Homeschooling your... Yes, that's bad. Or a bad surprise. Which one do you want? And given this is especially bad UI design, I did it on purpose, you'd say. I also have a fourth option, listening to Rick Astley from the 80s. That was bad. It's good these days. He actually made some good music, besides the point still. But what you'll see if I run my code again here is that I can choose one of the bad things, but I can only choose, and this one I can even, so what's going on? Well, what is going on is that what has the same parent, these bunch here, and these bunch in the other group, what has the same parent also goes into the same button group, unless you do something explicit. And this is what you've been waiting for all this time. Select this one, shift, select, no. So control, select, select. These are the three. And I'll right click and I will say assign to button group. I got a button group over here. Button group, I can even say, call it bad things one. There we are. And caps lock on again. That's why it says bad lowercase t. Anyway. The other thing, so now I want a new button group. So I check this one here, I right click and assign to button group. That was a good giveaway given that it was there. That was actually how I found it myself in some code I've written long ago. But I don't want to assign to this, I want a new button group. And that's where the hiddenness of this feature is. Still control. And this one down here. And if I have selected more than one and I right click, then there is the new button group. Yes, I don't know why it needs to be this difficult. Maybe one day I'll add a bug report on that, but now I know, now you know, so why don't we keep it to ourselves and we can be these superheroes that know stuff like that. Okay, sorry, I got carried away a few times being a smart ass and everybody wanna be a stand-up comedian, so what can I say? But I hope that it was actually worthwhile for you to see this video nevertheless. You could have done this in C++, and I have done it in C++ for the first 18 years of my career, until one day I stumbled upon, hey, you can actually do this with inside of Qt Creator, or with inside Qt Designer. And then I Googled, how do I really do that? And I found this trick. So I hope that helped you. Until next time, have a great day.